the splendor of heaven, knowing his destiny was the lonely hill of Golgotha, there to lay down his life for me. If that isn't love, the ocean is dry, there's no stars in the sky, and the sparrow can't fly. If that isn't love, then heaven's a myth. There's no feeling like this if that isn't love.
Even in death he remembers the thief hanging by his side.
Let me take this opportunity to say that I appreciate you watching us online or visiting us in service. It's also always a privilege. I had somebody stop by this Wednesday night and say to me that they'd been watching us online and how that the Word of God had touched their hearts, and that humbled me. And I pray that I can always preach the truth in love but also preach with conviction. So I appreciate you watching us. If you feel a desire and ever feel like the Lord's speaking to you to give to our local church ministries, I encourage you to do that. You can do that by going to easytithe.com and finding Prospect Church of God there. And you can do that. And I believe there's a QR code there that you can use there to take you directly into our giving website. We appreciate that. We are a small church with a big heart. And trying to do ministry is tough in the day we live. So I would encourage you to do that if at all possible. And not asking you to take tithe from your local church. Your tithe belongs to your local church, not ours. But maybe there's an offering that you would feel like giving to our church. And I'd really appreciate that. God bless you.
God, anoint Pastor Gann as he brings us the word. Lord, anoint our ears and hearts to receive the word, and let us live by the word and go by the word that we hear today and receive the word, Lord God. And I pray the Holy Ghost will do a work here, and he will have his mighty way here today. We ask in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Well, good morning. Good to see you this morning in the house of the Lord. Thank you for your prayers this week. Sister Gann and I got home last Sunday night, started chilling, 102 fever, and we've just been so sick all week long. And I just appreciate your prayers this week. But I'm glad I got to be here this morning. Praying, Sister Gann, to get to be here tonight. But it's good to see you. What a difference a Sunday makes. I'm telling you, from one Sunday to the next, and we've got people at plays, we've got people sick, we've got just lots of stuff going on, but I'm glad to see you in the house of the Lord today. Amen. I'm blessed to be here, aren't you? I said we're truly blessed to be here today. We could be a lot of other places, but God allowed us to be here today. And we need to worship him in spirit and in truth and thank him for his goodness and mercy. Ushers, please come this morning and receive our Sunday morning tithe and offerings. Thank you so much for your faithfulness, and thank you for loving Sister Gann and myself through this Christmas season. You're so kind and so good, and we love you. And please give today. How many know that smaller crowds usually mean smaller offerings? So I appreciate you really doing your best today, and I know that you will. I hope you haven't spent your tithe money on Christmas. Don't get quiet on me. Don't be having spent your tithe money on Christmas. Your tithe money is for the Lord, isn't it? And so I thank you for giving today. Amen. Patrick, pray, would you? Amen. Thank you, Lord. This morning, Lisa and Alan is not here. I'm not sure for what reason, but I know Jessica's going to do her best, and Shirley's going to do her best today and try to lead us in some Christmas songs. And let's just have a good day. Turn to the person beside you and say, you look better than when you came. Amen. All right.
Star of Bethlehem,
shining afar through shadows dim, giving a light for those who long have gone, guiding the wise men on their way unto the place where Jesus lay.
Shine on.
Oh, beautiful star.
Beautiful, beautiful star.
Of Bethlehem.
Star of Bethlehem. Shine upon us until the glow redawns.
Give us the light.
To light.
Land of perfect day.
Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on.
Oh, beautiful star, the hope of life, guiding the pilgrims
through the night. Star of Bethlehem, shine on.
Oh, beautiful star.
Beautiful, beautiful star of Bethlehem. Shine upon us till the glory dawns. A light to light the way unto the land
of
perfect day. Beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Come, let us adore Him.
Oh,
come, let us adore Him.
Oh,
come, let us adore Him. Christ the Lord. Before You alone are worthy, You alone are worthy, Christ the Lord. Thank You, Jesus. Amen. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Lord. Thank You, Jesus.
All right, if you want to turn in 408. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. Heaven and nature sing. Heaven and nature sing. Heaven and nature sing. Let sin and sorrow come. Thorns infest the ground.
He comes
to make
his
blessings. The curse is found, far as the curse is found. Far as the curse is found. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes
the
nations prove the glories
of his righteousness. His name is called Emmanuel. Is anybody glad he's Emmanuel, God with us this morning? You know, a lot of things might have happened and took place this week, and life happened, but aren't you glad Jesus never changes? He's God with us. Same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Isn't that wonderful? Same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Let's sing that one more time. Emmanuel. Yes, Lord. Emmanuel. Won't you lift your hands and just love him while you sing it?
His name is called. Hallelujah. Emmanuel. God in us, revealed in us. His name is called Emmanuel.
Won't you give him loud praise this morning? He's worthy. Would you go to a few people this morning and say, aren't you glad he's Emmanuel, that he's God with us? And just tell him how much you love him this morning. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. You may be seated this morning. God bless you. But good to see Brother Gary back this morning. I've been missing you, my friend. Good to see him and our visitors with Michelle and Gary this morning. Thank you for being with us today. All of our visitors, thank you for being here with us in the house of the Lord today. Sister Sheila, if you could hang around just a minute, I've got something I need to do before you leave this morning. Amen. It amazed me when I started thinking about the size of our church, of how many people that we have that actually every Sunday, Sunday in and Sunday out, give their time to serve the Lord, the kingdom of God. Do you know, when I got to counting them, we have 21 people that works every week to make it happen around Prospect. Isn't that wonderful? We have 21 people that works hard to make Prospect what Prospect is, and I appreciate them. And I surely wish that we could pay them every week. Not mean that. I wish we could just pay them every week. I wish we had the money, but we don't. We're not that size of a church. In fact, I believe if I'd ask most of these people, they'd say, I don't want paid. I think most of them would say, I'm not looking for a paycheck. But each year, we do our best to just say we love you and thank you for what you do. This is just a little token, believe me, it's just a little token. But how many are glad that one day there's coming a payday? Amen. Is anybody glad there's coming a payday? A payday that outdoes and outshines anything you've ever seen. But this morning, the ones that are here, I just wanted to give you some honor this morning and say thank you for what you do at our church. Daisy, would you come, please? Thank God for a good, honest clerk. Amen. Amen. That does a tremendous job. Just stay up here. That does a tremendous job at what she does. The clerk, besides the pastor, is understandably probably the hardest job in the church, to take care of the finances and oversee the finances. And Daisy, you do a great job. Would you thank Daisy for that this morning? Brother Jimmy, come on, Brother Jimmy. You talked about a right-hand man. Here's a right-hand man. I never, if the words almost get out of my mouth that I need something, Jimmy's there. Did you notice he left a while ago and went to he got me some water this morning. And not only that, but he's one of our assistant pastors and will do anything for this church. And a great preacher, getting better every time at his preaching. And don't you love Jimmy this morning? I love him for what he does. Yogi and Barbara, just come on up together if you would. Yogi, come on up. You're part of... Well, you're on the finance committee, aren't you? And count money and help it. Now, all those things. Come on, Brother Yogi. I've often said, if the world was full of Yogi and Barbara McDowell's, this world would be a really good place. They are just superb people, and I love them dearly. They've been with me from day one. They've been with me from day one, seen the ins and the outs, and I love them, and they're such great people. Barbara does whatever. She's just available. She just works with the kids and Yogi. He used to do work around the church for him. He's got too old and lazy to do that now, so now he's retired. He's helping us in our finance committee, and I appreciate that so much, and I love these two people right here. Amen. Amen. Danny and Kathy, would you come, please? I tell you, we were blessed, 2 years ago now, I guess it has been, when Danny and Kathy showed up at our church. You're talking about workers. These are workers. You didn't see yesterday, but the leaves are off the parking lot today because Danny was out there yesterday blowing the leaves off the parking lot of the church. They're faithful. If you look at our Facebook and you look at our YouTube accounts, it's top-notch. These folks do a great job in doing that, along with so many other things that they do in the church, serving on the finance committees and all of those things. And Danny and Kathy, I thank you so much for what you do for our church, and we love you greatly. Thank you. Amen. Won't you thank them this morning? Chris and Jessica. Chris and Jessica took the role a year or so ago as our family ministries coordinators and doing a great job at that. They'll be doing some other stuff this year along with trying to raise money for our children to go to Kids Fest here in just a couple of months. And they're just such an asset to the church. Both of them are just such an asset to our church. And we were so blessed. And don't ever call her a PA. She's not a PA. She's a nurse practitioner. I called her a PA, and she said, if you don't quit doing that, I'm going to call you a priest. Amen. But I love them so much. They're such an asset to this church. And I love both of you and your family. Won't you give them a hand this morning? Sister Glenda. Sister Glenda. Here's another one of those people that are just so busy around the church. Will do anything she can. Will do anything she can. Teach the classes or work in children's or anything that she's called upon to do. And she loves this church. And this church loves her. She's been with us several years now and just very faithful, and I love her so much, and her family just means so much. Won't you thank Sister Glenda this morning for her? Brother Patrick. What would we do without Patrick? Patrick came to us, about a year ago now, September, and just jumped right in there from day one and just became family and has taught and preached and done all those things. But he also heads up our men's ministry here at the church and does a great job with that. And I'm looking for more next year of greater things with our men's ministry. I love you, Patrick. Thank you so much for what you do for this church, and we love you so much. I'm just glad you're family. Amen. Won't you thank Patrick for his Sister Madeline, would you come, Sister Madeline? You're talking about a blessing just a few months ago, about a year ago now. Her and her sister showed up.
Yep.
And we're blessed to have Madeline here at our church. If you were here last Sunday morning,
yes.
And you saw the kids' production, mm-hmm. Now everybody was a team, but Madeline, all I heard was Madeline knows how to handle them kids.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
She knows how to handle them kids. And it might be because she's a school teacher. And so, but Madeline, thank you for what you do for our church and your sister. I wish she was here this morning, that violin that she plays. But Madeline, we love you and thank you for being part of Prospect. Thank you so much. Richard and Sharon. I know this is taking a little time, but it's worth it, believe me. Richard and Sharon and Richard have not been here a short time. Y'all didn't get that, did you? I love these folks right here. They've been with us several years now. Sharon oversees our children's ministries and does a wonderful job. Does a wonderful job at that. And our kids love her to death. And Richard teaches on Sunday morning and fills the pulpit. And one of the greatest Bible scholars that I've ever heard. And being able to quote scriptures. Patrick, too, and Jimmy, and all these guys. And thank y'all so much for what y'all do for our church.
Amen.
Thank you so much for what you do for Prospect. And we love you dearly. We love you dearly.
We love you dearly. We love you dearly.
Sister Sheila. Sheila is I say this with all my heart. Sheila's one of the most genuine Christians. One of the sweetest ladies that I've ever met. And just does tremendous job with her children and her nursery and everything that she does and puts up with Ricky. I'm telling you, this lady is just...
You're right there.
This lady is just amazing. And but we love her so much. And thank you so much, Sheila. Did you know one thing about her? I noticed that just... maybe a couple of weeks after a knee surgery, she was back in the house of God.
Amen.
That tells me a lot right there. That tells me a whole lot about an individual. And I appreciate you so much, Sister Sheila, for what you and your family do for our church. Amen. Sister Terry. Sister Terry oversees our singings, don't you?
Yep.
Okay, I couldn't leave you. It's a joy to have Terry and Mike here. They were gone for a season, and I missed you during that season. And I think God's going to use her even more in her church. And she works on her singings every fifth Sunday and gets all that organized and everything together there, and I appreciate her so much for doing all of those things. I pray that I haven't missed anybody. Shirley Lowe, right there. I forgot Shirley. I'm about to miss Shirley. If Bill hadn't been covering her with his arm, I might have been able to see her. Shirley Lowe, we love you so much.
Yes.
Shirley's been Church of God since Church of God was Church of God. Served over 50 years, I believe. Served over 50 years in world missions. 40, over 40 years trained, I don't know how many general overseers and world missions directors, and just did a great job. But Shirley Lowe, thank you for loving Prospect.
Amen.
And we love you. And you still do a beautiful job on that piano.
Yes, she does.
You do a beautiful job on that piano. And we love you and thank you for that. Amen. I hope I haven't. So you don't want to miss anybody, because they'll get you if you miss them. So I don't want to miss anybody. But would you stand up, the ones that are here today, and just thank these folks for what they do for our church. Thank you so much. And I'd like somebody, if you could, to get a photo of this morning. Would somebody be so kind to do that and send Pastor, Sister Gann's not here this morning, but I'd like for them to just get a picture of this morning and just let everybody see. Just come out here and, well, I'm glad your phone was off. That's the way it's supposed to be. You got it. Thank you, sir. All right, that's good. If that picture's not good, you're fired. Amen.
Thank you so much. God bless you.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. That just proves it ain't all about one person, is it? It's about a group of people that loves the kingdom of God. And there are several other staff wasn't here this morning, but thank you so much for your allowing me that time just to honor those great folks. Amen. Our children this morning, I believe, can be dismissed. I believe they can. Amen. Stand with me one more time, would you? I want us to sing that one more time before I bring what the Lord laid on my heart.
Emmanuel, Emmanuel, his name is called Emmanuel, God in us, revealed in us, his name is called Emmanuel.
If you have your Bibles, turn with me this morning to John chapter 14, if you would. John chapter 14, and we're just going to read one verse of Scripture. I really desire your prayers this morning. This has really been a very emotional, difficult week of the sickness in my body and my wife, and very, very physically weak this morning, but I don't depend upon the flesh today. I depend upon the anointing of the Holy Spirit to help me this morning, so I know that He will. John chapter 14 and verse 6, if you would, this morning. I want to talk to you this morning, as the Lord would help me, on that Jesus is the only way in a manger. That Jesus is the only way in a manger. John chapter 14 and verse 6, Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Father, would you please help me today? You know more than anybody here today the anointing that I need. And I pray today that you just grant me that, God, in Jesus' name. And that you would help me to share your word, God. That we'd leave here saying, I was glad that I went to the house of God today. And I will love you and I will praise you for it in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. We all know this morning that the primary purpose of the Bible is to present Jesus Christ, God in the flesh, who was miraculously born of a virgin, lived only the sinless life that has ever graced the globe, died a substitutionary death on the cross, rose triumphantly from the grave on the third day, and as Hebrews chapter 7 and verse 25 declares, that he ever liveth to make intercession for us, for those that come unto God by him. One of the greatest statements that I believe that Jesus made regarding himself and his purpose for coming into the world is found in the scripture that I read this morning. When he said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life, and no man cometh unto the Father but by me. I want to focus this morning on the part of that verse that Jesus said, I am the way. Would you say that this morning? Jesus is the way. I realized that he was making a statement in a specific connection in response to a question from Thomas. But in light of who Jesus was and is, and in light of all that the Bible teaches us about him, I believe it's also legitimate to apply that statement in all connections of life as well, that Jesus is the only way. So this morning I want to talk to you concerning those three applications of Christ's statement that I am the way. Can I tell you this morning that Jesus is the only way out? Man, I got to thinking about that. That Jesus is the only way out. That is, that he is the only way out of sin's condemnation and bondage and misery. There's no other way a man or a woman is going to get out of that sin life that they're in except through Jesus Christ. In John 8 and 34, the Bible said, whoever committeth sin is the servant of sin. The Greek word translated committeth in that verse is a term denoting a continuous action. So Jesus is speaking there of a person whose life is dominated by sin. In other words, that person's never been born again. They don't really know who Jesus is. John 8 and 34, the Bible said this, Jesus answered them and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, whoever committeth sin is the servant of sin. So what he was saying, that such a person is a servant, literally a slave of sin. Not only is he bound with eternal hell when this life is over, but in the here and now, he's captive of that sin nature. It has them bound. Here's a fact that people do not want to face. Matthew chapter 6 and verse 24 declares, no man can serve two masters. For either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold on to one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and mammon. You know, we have a lot of people that says they're Christians that are not Christians. I hate to tell you this morning, but if you're here in the sanctuary or listening to me online, if you don't have Jesus in your heart and you live right and you live holy and you live pleasing unto the Lord, please don't call yourself a Christian.
Amen. That's right, brother. That's
right. Please don't say that you're right with God when you're trying to serve both. Does anybody know what I'm saying? Because you can't serve both. You have to make a choice of who you're going to serve. Choose you this day whom you will serve. But it's for me and my house we're going to serve the Lord. So no man can do that. But when he meets God, when a man or a woman meets God, two conditions are set forth in Acts 20 and 21. Repentance toward God and faith of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He receives God's gift of eternal life and is miraculously set free from that miserable captivity that he was in. He has found from personal experience the truth of what Jesus said in John 8 and 36. If the Son, therefore, shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can I say this morning that the greatest gift that you could ever receive is to invite Christ into your heart and allow Him this morning, allow Him to make a way out in your life of the sin that you've got. I don't mean to be mean, but the doctors can't do it and the psychiatrists can't do it. All the medicines of the world can't do it. Your only way out of the sin nature that you have is through the blood of Jesus Christ. Is anybody glad of that blood this morning that you accepted? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Not only that, but he has found personal experience from the truth of what Jesus said. But there's another thing. Jesus is not only the way out of destructive actions, but he also sets us free from poisonous attitudes.
Amen.
Isn't that wonderful?
Amen.
Has anybody ever heard of Josh McDowell?
Yes.
One of the greatest writers. He's one of the greatest writers that ever wrote books. But I didn't know this, but in the 1970s, he told this story. He's effectively debated atheistic professors, but all of those things, he's so smart. But before his conversion, he had an uncontrollable temper. He said that he still bears the scars of a fight that he had in which he almost killed a man. But God, by his power, set him free from those awful fits of rage.
Amen.
And gave him control of his temper.
Amen.
Another of the horrific down-dragging sins in his life was the sin of hatred. Here's an excerpt from his testimony from a book called More Than a Carpenter. He said, I hated one man more than anybody else in the world. My father. I hated his guts. I was mortified that he was the town alcoholic. If you're from a small town, he said, and one of your parents is an alcoholic, you know what I mean. Everybody knows. My high school friends would make jokes about my father's drinking. They didn't think it bothered me because I fell in with the joking and laughed with them. I was laughing on the outside, but let me tell you, I was crying on the inside.
Amen.
I would go to the barn and find my mother beaten so badly she couldn't get up, lying in the manure behind the cows. When we had friends over, I would take my father out to the barn and tie him up. Can you imagine that? Take my father out to the barn and tie him up and park his car behind the silo. We would tell our guest he had to go somewhere. I don't think anyone would hate a person more than I hated my father. About 5 months after I made the decision for Christ, a love from God entered my life so powerfully that it took that hatred, turned it upside down, and emptied it out. And I was able to look my father squarely in the eye and say, Dad, I love you. Amen. You're talking about nothing else in the world can do that for a man or a woman, Sister Burris, that can take hatred like that and turn it into the love of God. Amen. He said his dad attempted to drink one more time after that and threw the bottle away from him and ended up his best friend for life. Amen. You may be here this morning and you're trying to get out of situations. Maybe you've got hatred in your heart. Maybe you've got something there. But I'm telling you, it's only through Jesus Christ that'll get you out of those situations. Amen. Not only that this morning, but Jesus is the only way in. Amen. Hallelujah. In reference to God having delivered the Israelites from Egyptian bondage, here's what Moses said in Deuteronomy 6:23. And he brought us out from thence that he might bring us in to give us the land that he sware unto our fathers. Man, I got to thinking about that. He brought the Hebrews out of their tragic life in Egypt that he might bring them into the land of promise. And in like manner, how many are glad this morning that when you surrender your life to him, that Jesus brings you out of that bondage into a brand new life in Jesus Christ. I can done see I'm going to have to cut this short this morning as much as I can. But I'm telling you, I don't know why people don't want the life that I have as a Christian. You know, some people believe that God is just this God that's the party pooper. You know, he wants you to have a good life. He wants you to have a good life. He wants your life to be happy. No wonder the enemy wants to fight us with everything that we are, because he wants to destroy that good life that we have in Jesus Christ. He gives us a brand new destiny, a home in heaven rather than in hell. Amen. So I'm glad this morning that he's the way in to that new life in Jesus Christ. You know, and most of us in this place this morning have not even really found out everything that God wants for us in this life. Amen. We really haven't. We haven't really experienced everything that God has in store for those that love him. Is anybody glad for that new life in Christ this morning? And I love him with all of my heart. Thank you, Lord. He's the only way into God's presence. John 14:6, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, and no man cometh to the Father but by me. Won't you give him praise this morning? He's worthy of our praise. Yes. Amen. Most of you can tell that I'm struggling physically, but I'll hair lip the devil before I not just share what the Lord put on my heart. And here's a big one. Not only is he the way in, but he's also the way through. We who have received Christ as our Savior are not exempt from life's reverses and tribulations. Several of you this morning are going through things today that you thought you would never go through in your life. You're facing things today that you never thought, disappointments, heartaches, and tears. But here's the difference as a believer. The Lord is with us through all of those trials. And will never leave us. I love what the Psalms 23:4 says. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Isaiah 41:10. Fear there not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God, and I will strengthen thee. And I will help thee. I'm glad he's the way through. I'm glad he's the way through.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Can I ask you this morning, are you dealing with difficult situations? Christmas can be one of the hardest times of the year. Emotionally for a lot of people. But he's the way through. I read the neatest little story about a missionary to Africa decided to go and preach to the people of a remote village. And because he'd never been there before, he was accompanied by a big, strapping native guide who was born and raised in that region. And no sooner had they begun their journey than they came to a section of the jungle where the vines and the undergrowth were so thick that it appeared they could go no further. And the missionary said to the native guide, "Do you know a way through all of this?" And the native guide drew himself a full height, took from his sheath a large razor-sharp machete, which he would cut away the vines and undergrowth. And as he smiled reassuringly, he said, "Yes, sir, I am the way. I am the way." Hallelujah. How many are glad that no matter what gets in our way,
yes,
that Jesus is the way? And he'll make a way. It don't matter how bad it seems and how terrible it seems, that God will make a way for us to get through. Is anybody like this pastor been going, I love the word through. Did you hear what I said? I love the word through. I love that. Oh, I may have to go through some things, but I'm going to come through. It may not be easy in this life, but I'm going to come through. Why? Because Jesus goes before me. Hallelujah. Amen. And he makes a way where there seems to be no way. Won't you give him praise for that today? He's worthy. He's worthy of our praise. Would you stand with me today? Those of you visiting this morning, I can promise you I usually do better than this. But God is good. God is so good. I'm just glad this morning that if you're here and you don't know Jesus, that he's the way out of your sins. You're not going to get out of your sins except a relationship with Jesus Christ. He's your only hope. Would you bow your heads with me today? Father in heaven, I love you. I thank you for your love and your mercy. Lord, if there's anybody here today that doesn't know you as Savior and Lord, would you please speak to their hearts today? Lord, your word does not return void and empty. Even though my body may be very weak today and I've done my best, your word will perform it. Hallelujah. And God, I ask you to touch hearts today. And I love you and I praise you. Could there possibly be anybody here this morning that knows that you need a way out? You need a way out of the condition of your life. You need a way out of your sins that you know that has you bound. The addictions that may have you just bound so bad. Can I tell you that he is the way out? He's the way into a brand new life, and he's the way through. Does anybody this morning might lift up your hand and say, "Pastor Gann, I needed to hear that I've got a way out. I needed to hear that there is a way out of my situations in my life, and I need to give Jesus a chance. I need to invite him into my heart and let him become Lord of my life." Would you raise your hand this morning and say, "Yes, Pastor Gann, I need a way out." You just don't even know this morning, but I need a way out. Would you raise your hand? I believe there's people here this morning right now. Yes, God sees that hand. I believe there's others. I need a way out. I need a way out, Pastor Gann, and you told me my only way out is Jesus. Somebody else this morning, please. Don't let the enemy talk you out of it. Is there anybody else? Is there anybody else? Here's what I need to ask you. Those of you that have raised your hand this morning, would you please meet me in this altar today and let me pray with you and others and let you find the way out? Would you please step out of your seats right now? Please, those of you that you raised your hand, just meet me right here and let me pray. Nobody will embarrass you. Be the greatest day of your life. Be the greatest day of your life. Would you pray with me, church? Pray with me, church. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. I beg you to come on. Don't let the enemy, don't let the enemy talk you out of the greatest gift that you could ever be given is a way out of your life, sin in your life and the things that has you bound. Would you please come? I beg you to please come. 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 Church, I need you to pray. Would you pray? Would you pray? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Jesus is sweetest name I know. Hallelujah. And he's just the same as his lovely name. That's the reason why I love him so. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For Jesus is sweetest name I know. Would you come this morning, please? Church family, would you come? Everybody come this morning. Don't anybody stand back. We do this every Sunday. Please come. Please come. Bring your friends there with you, Gary. I'd love for him to come this morning. Aren't you glad he is a way out this morning? The only way out. Is anybody trying to find other ways out? You thought you could find another way out? Some of you might have went to counselors and addiction clinics and might have went to all those places to try to get out, but you couldn't get out. You found that there's no way that you could get out. You tried. How many remember the day you gave Jesus a chance? I wish somebody help me a minute. Does anybody remember the day you gave him a chance? Sister Sharon, he brought us out. He got us out of that mess. He got us out of that mess. Boy, we were in a mess. Couldn't get out. We were in a horrible pit. Does anybody remember when he brought you out of the horrible pit and placed your feet on solid ground? He's the way in. Is anybody glad you found that brand new life in Christ Jesus? And he loves us so much. And he's the way through. We're going to make it. Turn to the person near you and say, we're going to make it. It's going to be all right. Because he's going to bring us through. Those that endure to the end, the same shall be saved. Thank you, Lord. Father, I pray for these that are up here this morning. Lord, I ask you in Jesus' name that you would touch every one of them. Lord, there's some of them that even said this morning that they needed a way out. And Lord, please don't let them leave here today until they give you that opportunity. And I will love you and I will praise you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Does anybody need special prayer this morning? Does anybody need special prayer?